When I was a young girl, there were very, very few women doing even biology, which is now, I think, much more accessible. I was never told by anyone I shouldn't study science, but I remember really, really well when I was in sixth grade, I had this boyfriend, and I remember I was doing better on the biology tests than he was. And I remember that there was this really big thing that I shouldn't do as well as him if I wanted him to be my boyfriend. It was definitely this kind of social stigma that, you know, that science was the domain of boys and men. As I was growing up after 12, it was my two sisters and my mother and I. And my mom was trained as an RN. She was amazing, especially after my father died. She always said, you know, that she wanted to make sure that we had access to the same kind of educational opportunities that we would have had if my dad hadn't passed away. I think when I really decided I wanted to be a scientist was after I graduated from college. I was attracted to it from a conceptual perspective because I really loved biology and I was curious about how the world worked. But I never really had a lot of experience doing science. I packed up my 1971 pale yellow VW bug and I drove to Texas and started working at UT Southwestern. The thing that happened when I was there is I realized how much I liked doing science, and I loved the kind of exploration of doing science. In my own lab, I've been really interested in what I would consider to be sort of a fundamental aspect of cell biology, which is really understanding how cells stick and how they move. What my lab has been able to do is to identify a new pathway, which is part of what we can kind of consider like the skeleton of the cell or the muscles of the cell. And so what my lab is really interested in is whether this pathway that we discovered might be responsible for that pro-metastatic phenotype or behavior of those cells. The thing that I really want to do before I retire is I want to see the science that's happening in my laboratory and the science that's happening in my collaborative team here at Huntsman Cancer Institute around Ewing sarcoma. I want to see that science be translated to the clinic where it can really have an impact on patients. It's estimated that more than 50% of all cancers could be prevented. And while we still obviously have to have a deep focus and commitment to new science that it can advance treatment for individuals who have a cancer diagnosis, wouldn't it be better if we could prevent the cancer in the first place?